It's Kaylee. This is the first video about greatest common factor. We're going to learn what the greatest common factor is and one method for finding it. Sam has 10 chocolate bars and 20 candies to give out to his friends. What is the largest number of friends Sam can give a bag of candy to if each bag of candy has the same contents and no candy is left over? Well, if Sam had just one friend, she would get all 20 candies and 10 chocolate bars. What if Sam had two friends? Each friend could get 10 candies and 5 chocolate bars. Now, what if Sam had 5 friends? Each friend would get 4 candies and 2 chocolate bars. Do you think Sam could have even more friends to share this candy with? To solve Sam's candy problem, we need to learn about the greatest common factor. Maybe you've seen this before as GCF. Do you know what it means? A greatest common factor of two numbers is the greatest number that is a factor of both. Okay, that sounds like really confusing, but let's work through this together and we'll figure it out. So Sam's candy question is really asking, what is the greatest common factor between 10 and 20? Well, the word factor really just means divisor. So what we're really asking is, what is the largest number that both 10 and 20 can be divided by? We can find this by listing all of the factors for 10 and 20. For 10, we know 1 times 10 is 10, and 2 times 5 is equal to 10. And for 20, we know 1 times 20 is equal to 20, 2 times 10 is equal to 20, and 4 times 5 is equal to 20. So all of these numbers here are our factors for 10 and 20. So let's write these out as lists. So for 10, I have 1, 2, 5, and 10. And for 20, I have 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, and 20. So let's take a good look at these two lists. We need to find the largest number that is in both of these lists. It looks like they both have a 1, they both have a 2, they both have a 5, and they both have a 10. And we know that 10 is the largest number that's matching in these two lists. So that tells us that the greatest common factor, or the GCF, of 10 and 20 is going to be equal to 10. And that would mean that Sam can give 10 friends the same amount of candy. Each friend would get 2 candies and 1 chocolate bar. Now you know what the greatest common factor is and one method for finding it. Join me in the next video called Greatest Common Factor Prime Factorization to learn another method for finding the greatest common factor. Hey, hey.